Great to hear pretty big audience today, it's Saturday. And my topic that I want to share is about management and methodology for management of what in our company is big project, and specifically management with Jira software, with Jira tools, and hopefully with some reference to Agile. What for you is a big project? Because we all come from different companies, local web design companies or big international giants. What is a big project for you?
Well,
100 developers on a project or 100 people? People, money, hours. Like in database, you mean? Like high load? Okay. Sure. Well, okay. Well, it's really nice to come to conference to go out of the box of our company, to understand that large is actually much larger than we are thinking about it. So, like assumption I made for this presentation is that you are either using Jira or similar software for management of projects. You tend to do things agile or Scrum based, and large for the purposes of this presentation is from 2,000 to 4,000 hours, like project in terms of hours or more. So this is 1 man year or 2 man years or 3 man years. So if something that you should do during 1 year, even alone, how would you manage this? Or say if we converted 100 people, then it's just, you know, for half a week. Still, you have to organize them somehow. So, why I thought it could be useful and decided to apply for the conference, because it works for us. And who are us? We are a web development company, open source, locally owned, so no connection to international giants. We do web development, and we cannot even run projects of 100 people because we are only 60. This methodology, this approach can help us efficiently finish projects that are of this scope of its web development, 2,000 to 4,000 hours. It helps us to not get lost under the mess of it and finish it within deadline and budget. And recently, it became our competitive advantage because we compete in all the world. Our customers, they can freely order something in China or India or in Ukraine or Belarus or Russia or in the same US or Canada. But they tend to choose us because due to some methodological changes we made, they see that we are not just a bunch of developers and project managers, that we are an organization. And that also helps us to increase hourly prices and win much larger projects for worldwide known brands. And we will start from it's best to describe this methodology from the start of a project. So when a project manager or a team of business analyst, architect, and project manager, they got a goal, and they start meeting customer. And usually, in our experience, it finishes or it gets involved into a cloud or a mess of all kind of buzzwords that one customer representative speaks about design, other speaks about integration, third starts speaking about marketing, fourth starts speaking about some very fine details of how front-end look and feel will actually look like. And then in a project that might span 6 months or a year, you are overwhelmed because you have a lot of different stakeholders and they all speak about different things. And you have no clue how even structure this cloud of customer wishes. They just want this and that, and they don't stop. And what was next? Okay. And this experience is particularly useful for companies that are small and plan to grow or experience growth. So probably not for international, like representatives of international giants, but for local Latvian companies. So what what you might do when you have a large project and you start using some collaboration software, and why we think Jira is useful, because it's kind of industry standard for at least open source developers. So you can just move this idea cloud to Jira and have something unreadable, unseen, like you unmanageable, like many hundreds issues that are pretty unstructured. You can start trying to work in sprints with this. But in Jira, you even cannot see entire set of your issues on a board, because they allow only to see the current sprint, so maybe 20 issues from this 500. Other 500 and other this 480 are just in one long line, and you do not understand what's going on with these issues. Are they specified? Are they confirmed by the customer? Are test scenarios written for them? Do they have some, you know, visual materials to implement? Are there still some pending questions on them? So it's a big mess that a company can face. So they start doing something, some 5% of a project, and other 95% are something. There is no word for it. So what we... How we solved this uncertainty problem, this mess problem, we started to create a separate board for backlog management. It has to be, in Jira technically, it has to be Kanban board, because only it will allow you to see all the issues you want on one board. And this board, an example I made up for the presentation. So a backlog board, instead of just having one list, you can at least create 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6, or 7 stages of your issue lifetime, from idea, when customer just told something, to the moment when you can actually put it to backlog for developers to check out and put for to do or to in progress. And sometimes it might involve columns like new, discovery process, specification, client action. Some issues can be put on hold, so you don't care about them. And so it helps to cycle somehow 500 or 1,000 items from new or from just I want this to something that developers can actually deliver. And you have very clear overview of what actually is going on in your project. How many issues, hundreds, are new, how many are already in backlog, how many are on hold, how many are in specification. Say client action status might tell you that you have to request something from client, that client has to confirm, do they need it, or they have to answer, how do they need it. So it helps you at least to split them kind of maturity-wise. Are they new or they are ready? They are mature for development. And solution two that works is to split these issues not only in their life cycle, but also split them in a hierarchy of project. And again, this is something like everyday life for big companies, international companies, but for Latvian companies, this is pretty seldom. Because in Latvia, you do not face big projects. Whatever project you do in Latvia, like our company was working in open source market in in Latvia for 6-7 years, doing some projects for like top 100 companies, and they're not anyway big. They're not anywhere big, like we are doing now when we are working for US, Canada, and all the world. So for local companies, it's something new to divide projects in components, epics, and issues. But for your backlog management, it just helps you to not only divide your backlog in columns, but also to divide it into components. Like to, you can add filters for component that deals with integration, initial setup, data import, backend experience, frontend experience, and clicking here, you narrow down your backlog to only issues that deal with this. So for example, if you meet with a customer representative that is kind of data, architect or you know, whoever is dealing with databases, then you just narrow it down to 7 issues you have to discuss with them. And all other 500 or 600 issues, you are not bothered with them. So components are helping. You know that components are some isolated parts of projects. And then you can, okay, it's not very seen here, but you can also, Jira allows you to create swim lanes and split issues by topics, by epics. So it can be, if we speak, like if we have a component of front end, it can be homepage or product page or checkout, for example. It can be a module like Epic within this component. And what kind of questions you have so far about it? Work in progress and limits we use for Kanban support boards. For backlog, we just put a quantity label there, so we know how many issues we have there in column. But we don't care so much if we have like too much in new or too much is on hold. We don't need to kind of make this green or red like it's necessary to put in support, at least in our company, because in support for work in progress, if it's more than 15, it means that okay, and we have constraint of 2 developers, then okay, it's red because we don't want to have more than maybe 10 issues there. But for backlog is management is not so resource wise constrained because we can just say if we see that we are overwhelmed, we can agree with customer to split it by sub projects, for example. So we do not yet put any color coded warnings. Iteration? So if just to understand your question better, say it's a backlog board, a sample of one project. Say issue starts somewhere on the wall as new. When we start to kind of overview it on high level, it moves to discovery. Then once we already understood more or less what the client wants and start to ask question and suggest some specification, we move it to specification. And eventually, I don't know what's open for now, but eventually it moves to backlog. So we do not try to run iterations in backlog management. We just, our purpose is to is to move from unstructured cloud of customer wishes that they just throw on us to land them in the new column of the backlog, structure them along components and epics, and then move with them either to backlog or to on hold, or maybe to canceled. So it's just step-by-step process that we, I mean, iterations, I understand iterations as like Scrum process. We finish script, we may sprint, we made retrospective, we iterate, so, but. You mean so we can just run like release of backlog? Yeah, we didn't run release of backlog yet. Like we can technically do it once we, and I mean I'm not sure we can actually do this. Well, we can configure it so it, then we can run release of backlog, say project iteration 1, for example. So we agree with client, okay, what we have specified so far, we see that it's already contains some finished components, some specified components, and then we can deliver, we can check, kind of move it to production team. So we can make a release, kind of release of backlog, and the benefit will be that we will clear these 600 issues from few hundreds maybe. Was it the question? Like, it depends. We are open. Some clients see it. An average cycle time, I think that if we run a project for 4 months, then I think average is 2 months. Like if we sign the contract and customer tells, I want the result in 4 months, then we start iterating. This issue is like iterating, I mean, from one column to another. And some issues might take 4 months. So basically, they will be specified until the deadline almost. And some can be specified within 2 or 3 days. And some can be specified only in the middle of project. So I would tell that this backlog, basically lifetime, is almost a lifetime of the project until delivery.
Do you have reference
to that? No. We'll keep trying and learning.
So as I understand, you're categorizing your all issues somewhere in the hierarchy, putting it under some components.
Yeah.
Have you tried something more like keywords or tags that issue can have?
No, I'm afraid of trying keywords and tags like and labels because they are too, like I personally like structure and control. If I give too much freedom for our project managers and clients, then one client put a label homepage, another puts index page, another puts start page, another puts whatever they want to put, and then we just have a cloud of some non-matching data. So our solution to this is that when we finish certain portion of high-level meetings with a client, then we define component and modules, and then we do not talk about labels or keywords or anything because we are kind of able to cover all the project within this kind of skeleton of components and modules. So we don't need to use labels or keywords there.
For example, you can put this is performance issue, like it has performance, and then this is related to some component, and then you can have views like find either all performance issues or this.
So it allows for kind of cross referencing. So like so far we have kind of linear view of project. So it's kind of components, and then in each component has modules. But we have no way to pick up issues from different components that relate to performance and say delegate them to kind of performance specialists to profile these pages and see actually are they really performance critical or not. Thank you very much. We'll do this because like we are a growing company and we are kind of facing challenges. We didn't face this challenge so far. We so far faced the challenge of converting a cloud into something manageable. Yeah, so then we see that, we have performance issues, but we cannot actually create a performance component because it's like performance issues, they touch all the components more or less. And how we efficiently delegate these issues to for performance manager review, for example. So now I know. Good. We'll use keywords. It is Agile Jira. Jira Agile. I think it was called Green Hopper. Yeah, it was called Green Hopper before, and we are using on-demand instance and. They always change it. So,
you can buy Jira basically without it.
Maybe it's like $100 per month or something, or per user. So. Yeah. So it will be just. So, like, standard Jira doesn't have this agile and tempo. So, standard Jira has dashboards, projects, and issues. If you want to have these boards, you buy agile, and if you want to time track, well, you can time track in Jira by default, but if you want to make more use of it, you buy a tempo plugin. Yeah, we We did some limited choice. We, like our company, historically, we started with managing of to-dos in a rich text editor in CMS. So we just made a table, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and it was columns. And rows were developer names, and we just putting their stuff, and they were marking this with green or yellow, and then we were doing something else with it, and it was like 10 years ago. Then we did our own system, then we did Basecamp. Parallelly, we've worked with all kind of other systems that our clients were using, like Trello, Redmine, Active Collab, and a bunch of others. We ourselves were using Basecamp, and then we just decided to give a Jira a try because we heard that Boeing is using it, so we decided. Okay. It's best if it reflects. It can be that some issues that we start in new, they can be, you know, expanded into more issues. But as such, the general structures that is split in components and epics, it should reflect basically the application design that you will deliver. Like we treat graphical design as component as well because it also has tasks. We shouldn't miss anything there. We want to keep it in the same place. And deployment procedure is also a component, or pre-launch simulation. It's also something quite isolated and has certain tasks. I'll move on to, because we basically spoke about backlog board so far, so high-level meetings, component and modules, then we register them all in backlog and then start moving them to certain degree of success. And why it's Basecamp there, because when you have 500 issues or 1,000, you have to somehow communicate about them, and email or Skype meetings are not good at all. And communicating in Jira comments, it's also that's pretty much difficult. And it just overwhelms Jira, and this kind of nice, elegant board becomes unmanageable. So for each topic we want to communicate, we create a Basecamp to do. Like if we want to ask customer about frequency of ERP synchronization or format and whatever, then we just create a separate to-do for it and we speak within this to-do about this subject. It helps to keep it kind of on the table of everyone, so it's not in the communication of two people involved, so as many people as necessary can be just clicked, and they will also get this comment. And you do not need even to go to Basecamp because you can just work with email and just hit reply, and it will be automatically appended there. Question there? Yeah. So far we never made agreements on delivering backlog. It was a project kind of milestone delivery or final delivery. So we are, there is no kind of stress to deliver backlog because it's actually what we don't want to do. We want to deliver backlog maybe in the 1 week before we deliver the project. And that's what we like, and that's possibly what is agile. Yeah, we are not agile masters. But and that's why here is a confluence. So when you start something from high-level meeting, you identify issue, you register it in backlog, you start communication in Basecamp, back and forth, you exchange information with client, and when issue is finally in backlog, you also push it to confluence. It's another Atlassian, like the same as Jira, Atlassian product, kind of a corporate wiki. So this is also structured along components and modules and the issues. And after issue is clarified, you push it there. So you deliver to the client a project wiki. So basically it's informative mirror of of entire development. So if in case they will lose everything, servers, repositories, local machines, they can recover it from the Confluence. Yeah, another thing that we added to the traditional Scrum boards in Agile is a backlog board and also big picture board, because sometimes clients just, or some important client representative calls and asks, what is happening with my project? I want to see big picture. I don't want to see details. I don't care about servers. I want my project and big picture. I'll try to... because it's not seen very well, but the big picture board, it combines all possible statuses of the project. So it combines all backlog statuses, like from new discovery on hold, specification, backlog. Then it combines sprint board statuses, backlog, in progress, failed quay, past quay or whatever, UAT, deployed to beta, deployed to staging, deployed to beta, deployed to production, done. And on this board, you can calm your angry or nervous customer, because you can essentially show him entire project cycle, split also conveniently in components and epics. So you can both show him general statistics on how many issues we still have in backlog, how many in progress, how many in quality assurance, and how are already done and accepted by his team. And we can also, if calmed client will want to speak about servers, you can efficiently with few clicks move to server side and show all, and also show, like, you can expand this swim lane and show that within this epic, like custom features or whatever, integration, there are some issues still on hold, some in failed quay, some in quay, some deployed to beta, some are in user acceptance, and finally some are done. So it just helps to overview entire project on one board. No, there's no need to manage it. It just automatically picks up all the issues from the project and just organize them. No. It's just a Jira board. So whenever, it's real time. Whenever developer picks something from backlog to in progress, you will see it here after you refresh it. And whenever another, like business analyst, moves something from specification to on hold, you also will see it real time. Okay, this is kind of entire workflow, but it's sum up, we more or less did it.